Well, Joe and Sarah, one of the honours of working on Studio 10 over the last 9 years has been that we all got to work with the one and only and become friends with the beautiful Jono Coleman. Without a doubt, one of the most special things to ever happen is being part of this show.
Yeah.
He was pretty close to something like our dad, wasn't he?
I just loved him more than anything. I adored him. We all, you know, we all hung out after the show as well and everything, especially once he got his diagnosis. Sarah.
Because I was pregnant at the time.
Sarah decided, right,
we're doing a woman club.
Like the little cavoodle he is, she goes, right, we're going to walk him every day. And we did, and we'd start walking after the show, and Sarah dragged me along as well, and we'd be walking along, and Jono would just be there, sort of, you know, behind us, just chatting away, out of breath.
It was like a podcast. Your own podcast.
That's right. And it was like having your own human podcast walking after you. But there was just another beautiful thing that Sarah did off the screen that people otherwise wouldn't know about. But and then, yeah, we just got closer and closer and closer, and we were... And there is literally not a day goes by that I don't think about him. I know. It's
absolutely
the same for you.
You two had a particularly special bond, you and Jono. Let's take a look back at some of the always funny and always dangerous moments with our special mate, Jono Coleman.
Can we please cue Cupid? I think I just threw up in my mouth a little bit. Jono, you're naked. You know that moment where you think, should I? Hi, Jono. What year were you famous?
I was famous.
Speaking of mofos, hi, Jono.
I've just sampled all the food for Sarah's upcoming nuptials, and I've also sampled the sheets and the bed linen for the honeymoon.
And there's a lot of controversy around Australia, all over Australia today.
Look at all this money in my wallet.
I think you were supposed to throw to an advertorial.
Oh, yes. ZZ Top.
Do you feel mashed?
I feel totally mashed.
Fried?
Fried and too much starch in the diet. That's the trouble.
Baked.
Talking.
You were baked in the 70s, weren't you?
Oh, we all got a bit baked in the 70s, but that's another story. That's why I got arrested, of course.
A wonderful ad break. We make the money this way. The advertorials and, of course, some of these wonderful ad breaks.
Jono has the softest hands.
They've never done a day's work.
Never.
I'm a concert pianist. I did say pianist.
Okay,
well, you'll crack his head. You'll crack his head.
We've had an absolute blast behind you.
I'm starting to get my...
Very nourishing.
Hello. What are you doing on the weekend, Sarah?
I'm not going to do anything to your leg, by the way.
We hope you had a great week. We love you.
Well, Santa doesn't like to get too close to the...
Well, OK.
Nothing.
I
don't
understand.
What's happening?
I always wanted to do that.
Well, can I just say hello to Mrs. Claus if she's watching? It's not what you think, darling. It's in the job description.
Thanks, Sarah.
Disrespect.
Coleman, you've got to be serious.
I am.
Oh, what wonderful memories. Studio audience, I didn't realise how much of a view you got of Jono from behind so many times. Special moments.
I know.
I mean, you just don't see television like that anymore,
no.
Do you? You know,
and how much fun is it? It's so much fun. And even talking about Jono, even as the clip's playing, we don't talk about him in past tense.
I'm still
in denial. Yeah, no, I still honestly can't bear to think about it. And I've got heaps of his memorabilia at home, and I still look at it, walk past it every day, and have a little bit of a...
Studio 10 actually gives out Jono awards to staff for big achievements over the years. So he's just always in our
He's
our
under
hearts.
The tree.
He's under the tree. Yeah. There he is. That's a Jono right there.
The little Jono under the tree.
Little Jono.
He'd be annoyed that he's not on top.